praise him enough.
Yeah.
And worthy of all his praise. He's worthy of all his praise. God, I pray for the glory of God and God by himself. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God supply all our needs. According to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. God supply our needs. All we got to do is magnify and lift him up. Give him all the glory. Jesus died so we can have peace. So we can have joy. That we won't be lost. Thank you, Lord. I come to save that which was lost. Come and make us free. The scripture tells us, "Whosoever the Son of Man make free is free indeed." God, after God made us free. You know, it was when I didn't want to be. God came in my life when I was going to do something else. But he came in and made me free. There's nothing like being free. You know, we're free to praise him. We're free to magnify him.
Yes.
We're free to lift him up. We're free to give him all the glory.
Yeah.
We are free. There's no excuse. We no longer have an excuse. Jesus took them all to the cross. No longer have excuses. Hallelujah. Thank God for Jesus today. Thank God for bringing us out this day. Thank God for the pastor. Pastor Arthur, thank God for him. Gave me a call to come this way. Hey, one thing about me, he doesn't forget about me. He always give me a call every so often. Thank God for it. So I'm going to tell you, well, I'm going to call you. When I get, I'm going to call you. I'm yet waiting on the call. I'm yet waiting on the call. The pastor offered up like a waiting. He gave me a call. He's worthy. God is worthy. I met him a long time ago. I was real young. Thinking about God then, but God was thinking about me.
Come on.
Yeah. He's good. Yeah. The scripture say, taste and see that the Lord is good.
Yeah.
Blessed is the man that trusts in him. Yeah. We give honor unto God on today. Thank God for the presence of the Holy Ghost. Thank God for the pastor Arvid. His first lady. Thank God for my wife. And everyone, all the ministers, sisters, pastor. We thank God for everyone in respectful places. God is worthy. My thought today is you don't have to fight in this battle. God, it's too little of fighting, but God wants to stop fighting. There's only one fight that we should be done. It's fighting a good fight of faith. That's it. Now, God will take care of your battle. We don't have to fight him no more. We just get sick. We go into the book of Chronicles. And I think before you long, we go into the book of Chronicles, 2 Chronicles. 2 Chronicles, the 20th chapter. And we're going to start at that 10th verse. So I want to read from
And now behold the children of Ammon, and Moab and Mount Seir, whom thou wouldest not let Israel invade.
God will let them rest, when the watch would happen. Read it.
When they came out of the land of Egypt. But they turned from them and destroyed them not.
God took all them right there. You know, sometimes, you know, you treat the person that, you know, you treat them real good. When God took care of them then, but God gave them mercy. And so when God gives you mercy, he wants you to do the same. The merciful shall obtain mercy. So look at God. Read.
Behold, I say, how they reward us.
How they reward us.
To come to cast us out of thy possession.
Now, this is something you gave to God. They come to pass us out of it. They come to cast us out of it. When you could have destroyed them, you didn't do it. You told us, let us turn from them. Watch this. Read it.
Which thou hast given us to inherit.
God, you gave it to us. Now, God gave us inheritance. Here comes something I'm trying to take away from you. God has gave you a life, He gave you a good health of body. Here comes the devil trying to destroy you. But watch this, read it.
Our God, wilt thou not judge them?
God, we not judge them. We ask God, of course, not. Watch this. Read it.
For we have no minds against this great company that cometh against us.
You know, certain things that are going on in our life, we don't have no mind against you. And so what we do, we should go to God, because the battle is not ours. Amen. It belongs to God. So God wants to come to Him. God wants to seek Him while He may be found. He wants to call upon Him while He's near. And this is time now for us to seek the Lord. With all our heart, with all our mind, with all our soul, with all our strength, He wants to seek Him. And He told you to do the same. He said, love me with your heart, with your mind. I want you to love me. I want you to love me. And after you love Him, He told you to love. He told me to love my neighbors as I do myself. It's something. Now, those things, you know, we preach a lot of this message, but they always end up being, you know, kind of the same message. Get out of here. Because one man preached a message for 120 years, the same message. And all the world ain't gonna rain. It's gonna rain. And then nobody listened to that message. Only the one who came out of that without being drowned was his family. And the one we think ain't listening is the one listening. So God wants to preach this thing over and over and over. Read it.
Neither know we what to do.
God, I got to a point, God. Somebody like that right now. We don't know what to do. Come on, you in here with me. I don't know what to do. Watch this. Read it.
But our eyes are upon thee.
Now sometimes you think you really think it, but probably at the time thought he know what to do, but he really knew what to do. Come on now. He really knew what to do. My eyes is upon you. So when you have your eyes upon God, you know your answer is taken care of. Your problem is taken care of. Your joy, your peace is taken care of. When your eyes are up on God, see, we put our eyes on the physical things. But God said, put your eyes on the spiritual thing. Put your eyes up on God. God, my eyes are up on you. I don't care what's going on in my life. I don't care what's coming against me. But my eyes is up on you. And that's why deliverance comes from. Our healing comes from our eyes being on God. Plus trust in God. The scripture tells us the world, the weapon of our warfare are not carnal, but light from God to the pulling out of strongholds, casting out imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bring every thought. Come on now, bring it. Bring every thought in the captivity of obedience of Christ. Come on down and see what God said. You know, sometimes we want to fight, and God said, bring them in. The fight is not yours. You don't need to fight in battle. All I need you to do is just run away. Watch this. Read it.
And all Judah stood before the Lord.
And not some of Judah, but all Judah stood before the Lord. God looked for all of us to stand before Him. Come on, let's stand. Stand in your mind. Stand in your spirit. Stand. Stand on your feet, whatever it takes, long you stand before God. Because we all have to come before the judgment seat of God. Why would I break that day when I can stand before Him now and get it all together? Watch this. Read it.
With their little ones.
With the little ones.
Their wives.
And you know, we want to leave the little one and the wife at home. But God's not. We want to leave them at home. But now, watch this. With the little ones. With the wife.
And their children.
And the little ones, the wife, and their children. I don't care how old they get, they're still your children. You know, you want them to be there with you. Mm-hmm. Now, when I started serving, when I started church, my sons, it seems like they just ain't at home, but my daughters are right there with me.
Then upon Jahaziel, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jeel, the son of Mattaniah, and Levite of the sons of Asaph, came the Spirit of the Lord in the midst of the congregation.
See, you know, when we're looking for Alex somewhere, you know it's right there in your midst.
in evidence of things that not seen.
Watch this, watch this. Read it.
Be not afraid nor dismayed.
I want you to lose no courage. Don't be afraid and don't be dismayed. Stop being afraid. God wants to stop being afraid. When you want something to go on in your life, you don't know what to do about it. Yes, I do. But the prophet said, I don't know what to do, but my eyes is up on you. When you don't know what to do, put your eyes on God.
Yes.
He is our healer. He is our deliverer. He is our waymaker. He is our peace. He is our joy. Put your eyes on him. God, I don't know what to do about this situation, but my eyes is up on you. Don't be afraid. Don't be dismayed. Why?
By reason of this great multitude.
God don't care what's coming against you. I don't care what's going on in your home. I don't care what's going on in your marriage. I don't care what's going on with your church. Because it might be a great multitude, but don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. You might lose your job, but don't be afraid. All things are working together for the good of them that love God. To them that are called according to his purpose. I'm telling you.
What he say, he means it. Whatever he tell you, he mean it.
Yeah.
And we'll tell people stuff and know he don't mean it. Come on, what we doing? Come on now, what we doing? But whatever the Lord tells you, he means it. If he tell you, I'm going to be with you, he means it. He ain't saying something else to be saying. Like something else, we just say something else to be saying. We try to make friends with somebody. Don't tell them, I tell you what you want to hear. But God ain't trying to make no friend with you. He is your friend. God is our friend. Got him. Watch the green.
And ye shall find them at the end of the brook.
And this is what you're going to find. When you're troubled, you're going to find them at the end of the brook. We want you to know what's going on because you ain't gone, you ain't going the way he told you to go. When you start, when we start going the way God tells us to go, we see everything just so clear. We can see it so clear. When we are going the way God said go, and I can't help from seeing what he said go, and you're going to find it. He said he's going to find you. He said you're going to find it at the end of the brook. Watch this. Read it.
Before the wilderness of Jerusalem.
Read it.
You shall not need to fight in this battle.
Oh, in trouble. Right. Yeah. Then we get when the things y'all have in our life, we get sanctified. We get holy with the things y'all have. But God wants you, He wants you to do it when things are going good. He wants you to serve Him when everything is so good. That's when He really wants you to serve Him. Come on, serve Him. Don't wait till you get sick. And all part of I'm ready to serve Him now. How you ready to serve Him when you got a leg working? Wait, ready to serve Him when you got a leg working? God wants to use us while he calls the young people back. Because they are what? Strong. He calls you to be strong. God can do a whole lot with you when you're strong. He wants you, God wants you. I started serving God at 29. Oh, God blessed me so much. He changed my mind about a lot of things. I had to pray away at the time. But God changed them for me. The battle is not yours, but the Lord. You don't need to fight in the battle. All I need you to do is get yourself still. Come on, get still. Just sit yourself. Sit yourself still. Stop moving. I can't catch you on the back if you're moving. It's hard to catch you on the back when they're all over the place. I can touch you. Stop moving. Get set.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Get set. And that's your job. All I need you to do is just get set. I'll take everything else for you. If you just get set in your mind, I'm going to serve you, God. In your spirit, I'm going to serve you, God. The way I think, I'm going to serve you, God. I'm going to lift you up. I'm going to magnify you. I'm going to give you the glory. I just had a word that they start going on in my life. But God will do what they will do with you.
Amen.
Watch this. Read.
Stand ye still and see the salvation of the Lord with you.
You know, it's kind of hard to see something when you're not standing. You're moving too much. We can't see God blessing you, God. What? Moving too much. I've been there. I was just moving too much. You know, I was looking for God to do certain things for me and couldn't see the God. I wasn't still. I couldn't see God doing nothing. Because I was moving too much. I just want to believe God doing nothing. I was moving too much. And God had to back it with me. Get yourself sit still. Come on, get that mindset. Work on that mind. It's balance. Did you know what it's balance? All that God is to you in your head. But God said, no, don't listen to him. Come to me, all you that labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke on you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your soul. For the word of the life and my yoke is easy. And when you're in the world, man, they'll weigh you down so long. They'll weigh you down so you can't even lift up a hand. That devil will weigh you down with the sin of this world. He'll weigh you down so low you can't even raise up. Let's get yourself set. Get set. Get set. You run the race. You run this. Get yourself set so you can run this race. Sit before you. Look into the eye and finish your faith. Who for the joy to sit before him and do the cross? And do it. Despite the shame. Now sit down. Now Jesus will sit down. You sit down now. He said at the right hand of the Father. Is that where you want to sit?
Yeah.
You can't do it without running the race. See, we try to sit down with God, and we ain't even got in the race. There's no running one.
Man.
Get in the race. He didn't give it to the swift, not the strong. But he gives you the one that finished. It's time to finish. You know I'm getting old. It's time to finish the race. Ain't no time to play.
Set yourself standing still and see the salvation of the Lord with you.
I want you to see this thing. I want you to see it. See me with you. See the salvation of the Lord with you. See, we think, you know, when God saved us, you go into it, you know, He saved. When He saved you, all everything come with it. Healing come with it. Deliverance come with it. Peace come with it. We think, oh, I got salvation saved. No, no. It's more than come with it. When you marry your wife, who are you for? You told us to do it always.